All right, let's go on to headline number five. Chris, this headline number five has quickly become our A&M put you on the spot question.
It has.
Rotating spot.
It's weird.
So according to CNBC, Nike and Dick's Sporting Goods are teaming up and integrating their loyalty programs. Chris, Chad Lusk wants to know, what are you, Chris, more excited about with this move from Nike? Exclusive Nike goods on Dick's Sporting Goods website? The potential to pick up Nike D2C product at the Dick's stores, or something else that you would like to come out of this beautiful marriage of two major retailers?
Yeah, that was some good drama in that read, Ann. Excellent on the drama.
So full of drama.
Well, that is a great question from Chad. Chad always brings it for me every single week, and I always appreciate that.
And you know what? I bet he gets my Bone Thugs and Harmony reference.
I bet you he does. Yep, for sure he does. But anyway, to bring people up to speed here, in a first step, Nike's loyalty program is going to link to Dick's membership offering to allow customers to shop for exclusive Nike shoes and apparel on Dick's website. And the two also hinted that there's another perk that could be coming that allows Nike customers to drop off their returns or pickups at Dick's stores. So, God, where do I start here on this question?
Yeah, what are you
Chad?
Excited about?
I mean, for me, there's a number of takeaways from this. I think first, questions were always out there in terms of how far Nike would go in cutting its ties with its wholesalers. And I think this shows that it's not going to be that far. And let that be a lesson, I think, for everyone listening, because good omnichannel retailing is never about all one way or all the other. And we constantly see that in the media. Mm-hmm. It's about placing your bets and finding the right balance across everything that you offer to meet your consumers' needs where they are. The other thing I think this calls to mind for me is that omnichannel is not sexy. Like, I've told this anecdote before, probably like 2 years ago. And you remember this. We were at Shop Talk 2018. There was some exec from Nike on stage. Mm-hmm. Talking about their omnichannel philosophy. And I came out and I said to somebody who I respect a hell of a lot, and I said, I thought that was great. And they were like, oh, it was so boring though. Like, there was nothing cool, exciting. I'm like, yes, that's the point.
Yeah.
And yet people don't get that enough. And so I think this is, you know, they're conjoining their membership programs. That's mm-hmm. freaking awesome.
Yeah.
I think it's groundbreaking. So I think of all the aspects to answer Chad's question, I think there's a lot of ground to mine there, especially when you talk about the advertising networks that are popping up. If Nike can figure out how to do that with the right partners and just inculcate themselves more mm-hmm. into that and make it seamless, and then you throw the returns on there, which is always a problem with shoes, I think it's great. I was trying to wrap my head around something, you know, new I'd want to see, mm-hmm. but nothing's coming to the top of my head on that. I'm curious what you think.
Well, the thing that if I'm going to throw something new in there, I think the thing that, as a mom with kids who are in youth sports, Dick's is pretty involved, I would say, in the youth sports communities, from like being able to give special discount weekends when the sports seasons start, that kind of thing. I think that allows Nike to like kind of further embed in some of those community-based programs. In addition to, you know, Nike now having a presence, a bigger presence and more of a presence in every Dick's Sporting Goods location, the existing stores, and then all these new formats that they're coming out with, from, you know, the soccer fields to the, you know, the variety of things that Dick's is coming out with. I think that we've already seen a big push in the beauty space with this. Target merged their rewards programs with Ulta, so that, you know, it matters to people. Yep. Those places that are repeat purchases for people, sporting goods for your kids and for your family, beauty products that you're buying over and over again. Like those are some of the most successful rewards programs, and they are driving where people are going to shop for those items. And so I think that this is a really brilliant place for Dick's and Nike to start. And I think that it's going to, especially once you start to integrate the physical benefits, like you were mentioning, returns and other things that you can do in store, drops that can start to happen in store. I think that's going to just continue to make Dick's a destination and be successful for Nike too.
Yeah, that's interesting. The one part of it I thought about what's next would be like the youth sports. Like, how do you just own that between the two of you? Mm-hmm. And the other thing too that you made me think of too, Dick's been getting into more of the kind of the outlet or the returns outlets. Yep. So this kind of plays into that too, and kind of puts a kind of shot across the bow of the marketplace activity that goes on around that.
Yeah, and I think just to wrap up, I just add too, like, I think that this also captures a more broad audience. If you look at, it was just at the Nike store last night, if you look at their selection versus the selection at Dick's Sporting Goods, I mean, those Nike stores are fun and beautiful, but there's not a lot that, like, my kid's not buying their Nikes there. We've gone to Dick's Sporting Goods. The selection's wider. You can get more than one thing, you know, more than just like the elite elite lines that are out right now. And so I think that this is just helping Nike provide more access to their product in a physical space.
Yeah, makes you wonder what's next to Foot Locker or whatever.
Yeah, I was surprised about that. I was kind of surprised what happened with Foot Locker. Like, how's Foot Locker feeling about this?
Yeah, I bet they're probably working on it too, would be my hunch. Lover. But yeah, jilted lover. Yeah.